and help my heart to understand. In Jesus' name, amen. Enjoy the show.
At that time, the kingdom of heaven will be like 10 bridesmaids who took their lamps and went to wait for the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 of them were wise. The 5 foolish bridesmaids took their lamps, but they did not take more oil for their lamps. The wise bridesmaids took their lamps and more oil in jars. Because the bridegroom was late, they became sleepy and went to sleep. At midnight, someone cried out, "The bridegroom is coming! Come, meet him!"
Then all the bridesmaids woke up and got their lamps ready. But the foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, because our lamps are going out." The wise bridesmaids answered, "No, the oil we have might not be enough for all of us. Go to the people who sell oil and buy some for yourselves." So while the 5 foolish bridesmaids went to buy oil, the bridegroom came. The bridesmaids who were ready went in with the bridegroom and to the wedding feast. Then the door was closed and locked. Later, the others came back and said, "Sir, sir, open the door, let us in." But the bridegroom answered, "I tell you the truth, I don't want to know you. So always be ready, because you don't know the day or the hour that the Son of Man will come."
The kingdom of heaven is like a man who was going to another place for a visit. Before he left, he called his servants and told them to take care of his things while he was gone. He gave one servant 5 bags of gold, another servant 2 bags of gold, and a third servant 1 bag of gold, to each one as much as he could handle. Then he left. The servant who got 5 bags went quickly to invest the money and earned 5 more bags. In the same way, the servant who had 2 bags invested them and earned 2 more. But the servant who got 1 bag went out, dug a hole in the ground, and hid the master's money. After a long time, the master came home and asked the servants what they did with his money. The servant who was given 5 bags of gold brought 5 more bags to the master and said, "Master, you trusted me to care for 5 bags of gold, so I used your 5 bags to earn 5 more." The master answered, "You did well. You are good and loyal servant. Because you were loyal with small things, I will let you care for much greater things. Come, share my joy with me." Then the servant who had been given 2 bags of gold came to the master and said, "Master, you gave me 2 bags of gold to care for, so I used your 2 bags to earn 2 more." The master said, "You did well. You are a good and loyal servant. Because you were loyal with small things, I will let you care for much greater things. Come and share my joy with me."
Then the servant who had been given 1 bag of gold came to the master and said, "Master, I knew you were a hard man. You harvest things you did not plant. You gather crops where you did not sow any seed. So I was afraid, and I went and I hid your money in the ground. Here is your bag of gold." The master answered, "You are a wicked and lazy servant. You say you knew that I harvest things I did not plant and that I gather crops where I did not sow seed. So you should have put my gold in the bank. Then, when I came home, I would have received my gold back with interest." So the master told the other servants, "Take the bag of gold from that servant and give it to the servant who has 10 bags of gold. Those who have much will get more, and they will have more than they need. But those who do not have much will have everything taken away from them." Then the master said, "Throw that useless servant outside into the darkness, where people will cry and grind their teeth in pain."
The Son of Man will come again in his great glory with all his angels. He will be king and sit on his great throne. All the nations of the world will be gathered before him, and he will separate them into 2 groups as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. The Son of Man will put the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to the people on his right, "Come, my Father has given his blessing receive the kingdom God has prepared for you since the world was made. I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was alone and away from home, and you invited me into your house. I was without clothes, and you gave me something to wear. I was sick, and you cared for me. I was in prison, and you visited me. Then the good people will answer, Lord, when did we see you hungry and give you food, or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you alone and away from home and invite you into our house? When did we see you without clothes and give you something to wear? When did we see you sick or in prison and care for you? Then the king will answer, I tell you the truth. Anything you did, even for the least of my people here, you did for me. Then the king will say to those on his left, Go away from me. You will be punished. Go into the fire that burns forever, that was prepared for the devil and his angels. I was hungry, and you gave me nothing to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me nothing to drink. I was alone and away from home, and you did not invite me into your house. I was without clothes, and you gave me nothing to wear. I was sick and in prison, and you did not care for me. Then those people will answer, Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or alone, away from home, without clothes, or sick in prison? When did we see these things and not help you? The king will answer, I tell you the truth. Anything you refuse to do for even the least of my people here, you refuse to do for me. These people go off to be punished forever, but the good people will go live forever.
The Bible says Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and that no man comes to the Father but through him. The only way to get to God is through Jesus. Jesus died on the cross to forgive all of our sins. If we ask him in our heart, he'll forgive all our sins so that we can be with God forever in heaven. Would you like to ask Jesus in your heart? Pray this prayer with me. God, thank you for sending your son Jesus to die on the cross for my sins. I ask you in my heart, be with me forever. Help me to live a life that is pleasing to you because I love you. In Jesus' name, amen. If you have a pet that you would like to see on a special episode, have your parent or guardian email me at the email address below. The email should include your pet's name, a Bible verse you would like to hear him read, and a forward-facing photo of your pet. If you would like your name and age included, add that to the email as well. Each time we have 10 entries, we will make a special episode. If you loved this episode, like our channel, subscribe, and ring the bell. See you next time.
Thanks for watching the show.